Hello, I'm Laken McGee.
And I'm Samantha Bowers.
And welcome to Show Me Chefs. Chefs is a new show where talented local chefs who have world experience use locally sourced foods to whip up some fantastic dishes.
Our chefs will put together a three-course meal for a panel of judges. They will then be graded on several factors: the overall presentation of the dish, the color of the food, the smell and texture, and most importantly, the taste. Laken will be with our chefs while I check in with our judges.
Today's show features two prominent chefs from the Springfield area. Our first chef is Chef Wes Johnson from Metropolitan Farmer.
Okay, Wes, so tell me, who got you inspired to start cooking?
I grew up on a small family farm here just north of Springfield, and we always had lots of great product available, fresh, so just kind of started cooking at a really young age.
Okay, well, good luck to you today.
Thanks.
The next chef we have is Chef Tony Garcia from Avanzare.
So, Tony, can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm a chef owner of Avanzare's restaurant, and I've been in Springfield since 1998, and I love it. I've been cooking and drinking and eating food, so
I love that combination.
And
good
I've been ready for that guy right there.
Today we have three judges who represent many facets of work from around the Springfield area. The judges we have today are Mark Biggs, Associate Dean from the College of Arts and Letters at Missouri State University, Melanie Grand from the Restaurant and Hospitality Department at Missouri State University, and Larry Gifford, owner of Ozark Mountain Coffee and Kathy's Pasta right here in Springfield. Laken, back to you.
Our chefs go through three time rounds of cooking using mystery ingredients provided by local businesses. The winner of today's quarter round will move on to the semifinal round of Show Me Chefs. So let's get started. Now is the time for the mystery ingredients. We have fresh onions, fresh cilantro, and mussels from our pantry provided by Mama Jean's. And our highlighted ingredient, salted caramel from Uncommon Confections.
Chefs, you will have 20 minutes to complete your appetizer. If you're ready, your time begins now.
Don't get nervous, bro.
Are you talking to me?
I'm just saying.
All right.
When we come back, our chefs continue their battle in the appetizer round.
Some garlic?
Challenge. No, I'm good. Thank you, though.
He says, I'm trying to be nice to you. So, they're both the same. There's nothing.
That cilantro was going to be in there somewhere, didn't you?
Mm-hmm.
All right, chefs, you have 10 minutes remaining. We're halfway there. All right, so judges, our highlighted ingredient is caramel, mixed with onions and parsley. How do you think those are all gonna come together in our appetizer round here? Judge Mark, what are your thoughts?
Well, I like caramelized onions, so it could be really nice.
Yeah, that's an option, you know.
Yeah. I would think that would work.
Yeah, Judge Melanie, how do you think they're gonna incorporate the caramel?
I think it'll be okay as long as they can put an acid with it to cut that sweet, but I think it actually will go together. At first I was like, but I, from the other fragrances and everything, it's gonna work.
Judge Larry, so the sweetness of the caramel, how do you think that's, are you a sweet or a savory person?
I'm definitely a savory person, but I won't discount these guys being able to pull anything out. You know, something's smelling real good right now.
Now let's learn a little more about uncommon confections.
When I was in college, a neighbor of ours taught me how to make peanut brittle. I wanted to kind of make a little extra money, and a friend of mine said, why are you not doing something with your candy? So I kind of took the plunge and decided to start this and found this place to cook, which Infused Catering's been kind enough to let me use their kitchens to cook. I've got three different flavors of toffee. I have cinnamon toffee, the chipotle toffee, and then I have just a basic toffee, which is kind of like a Heath bar. And then I have the peanut brittle and the salted caramels. These are treats that we all grew up with and candies that go back to my grandfather's time, but they're a little bit different than you would find in the store or find at even other candy stores. So that's why I decided on Uncommon Confections.
You got the wine anywhere, compadre? Are you drinking all the white wine?
No, not drinking at all, but I should. Here you go, sir.
Thank you, compadre. Need three of those.
All right, Tony, how are you feeling about this?
Feeling pretty good.
Feeling pretty
My
good.
Partner, on the other hand, he's
really?
A little nervous.
You think you have the upper hand right now?
He's nervous.
All right, well, I'm gonna go check in with him. So your competitor feels like you're falling a little behind.
Oh, no, we got a good 5 minutes. He's just too far ahead of himself.
Oh, is he?
Yes.
All right, so how do you feel like the judges are gonna like your dish?
Oh, I think they'll enjoy it quite a bit. But again, you know, it's a tough battle because Tony is, these are ingredients Tony's used to using, so okay. It'll make it a little more challenging for me.
So, Judge Melanie, as a part of the restaurant and hospitality department at Missouri State, you're probably around food and cooking quite a bit. Can you tell us how that sparked your interest and how this is going to affect your judging?
Well, I started cooking when I was 4, and so I've been a foodie for a long time. And but one thing, I'm actually pretty gracious when I judge, because I've been there before. And so I don't think I'm going to be one of the tougher judges.
Chefs, you have 1 minute remaining. Chefs, you were asked to create an appetizer using the given mystery ingredients. The time has now come to present to the judges. The judges will be grading your dishes on several factors: the presentation, the aroma and texture, the taste, and the use of the mystery ingredient. The judges also have up to 2 bonus points they can give to a chef of their choosing. Chef Wes, please tell the judges what you have made for them today.
We have a white wine and onion steamed mussel with a onion salted caramel marmalade, of vinegar cream and cilantro oil.
When you opened the package and saw the caramels, what was the first thought that went through your mind?
Sweets and seafood are a tough combo.
Yeah.
And when I saw all the other ingredients too, I mean, like I was saying, it really plays to Tony's wheelhouse. He's very comfortable with, you know, seafood and onions and, you know, that almost Italian-y feel of stuff. We're a farm-to-table restaurant, so I don't work as much with seafood. We work with a lot of local, you know, local fish, things like that, so we don't bring as much in from the coast.
So the cream sauce is a vinegar sauce, you said?
Yeah, so it's a mostly cream reduction, and then I finish with a little bit of vinegar to kind of cut through some of that fat and balance it out a little better.
You know, I thought it'd be like really sweet. It's not. It's perfect.
No, the creaminess and the salt really really helped.
It does.
It made it complement.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm gonna eat one more.
Well, and you know, one of the advantages, one of the good things I have is we constantly are challenged in the restaurant to invent new dishes because we have no idea what some of our farmers are bringing us. So there's new products every day, 6 days a week that we have to create new dishes around. So constantly works that part of the brain.
Thank you, Chef West. You may return to your station. Chef Tony, please tell the judges what you have prepared for them today.
So I just did, of course I did the mussels, but I caramelized the garlic, the onions, the curry, with orange zest in there too, and a little orange juice, the white wine, and the cilantro.
I particularly liked the little added caramel on the side.
Just in case it wasn't enough on the plate.
Those tomatoes.
And put the mushrooms there so that it cleans your palate in case it's a little spicy, so the mushrooms will clean it out.
Why did you choose to present it in a bowl, almost like a salad as opposed to on a plate?
Well, because one of the reasons too, he was going first, and then probably the mussels probably get cold really quick, so I did something to do that. And sometimes easy to garnish in a flat plate would probably be easier, a little lazy, but I had a little more time when it was done, so that's what I did that and put it together.
Oh, that's fantastic.
The caramel is kind of like a hidden food. Like it's not pronounced, but if it wasn't there, you'd probably miss it.
All right. Thank you, Chef Tony. You may return to your station. The judges will take their final bites. Coming up, the chefs prepare to square off in our entree round. Welcome back to Show Me Chefs. Before the break, our chefs had to create an appetizer using the given mystery ingredients. After 20 minutes of cooking, they created some fantastic dishes for the judges to grade.
Now is the time for the entree round. Each chef will have 40 minutes to prepare an entree using the mystery ingredients. Chefs, your ingredients are: we have red peppers and artichoke hearts from our pantry, ground beef from Ozark Natural Foods, and the highlighted ingredient, ground European blend coffee from Ozark Mountain Coffee.
Chefs, you will have 40 minutes to create your entree. If you're ready, your time begins now.
All right.
So if you guys give me alcohol, I can definitely do something with this.
You or for the dish?
More for me than the dish, buddy.
Still trying to figure it out?
Yeah. And a first flavor. I really hate to be that fancy. Oh, that's it right here. It's not Italian, but that's where I got it. That. Cutting the wine for that guy. Huevo. My gloves. Spicy.
Tony, can you tell me what you're going to be doing?
I'm going to make spaghetti meatballs.
Spaghetti meatballs, okay.
He knows it was coming.
Your competitor?
Yeah, he know it. I make a giant meatball in the restaurant, but I'm going to make small ones because I want to make sure my partner doesn't get ahead of me.
Are you going to use the tomatoes and asparagus?
I'm going to use the tomatoes, asparagus, the artichoke hearts, and a lot of extra loaf in there.
All right, well, good luck. Okay, Wes, what are we doing over here?
We're making cooking off some sweet potatoes for the starch to go with our I'm making a meatloaf. Tony probably saw that one coming too.
Okay, is meatloaf your specialty?
No, but a lot of what we do at the restaurant is farm to table, a lot of contemporary American stuff. So we have a tendency to lean toward home style, things from turn of the century, things our grandparents would have eaten.
Okay. All right, well, good luck to you today.
Thank you.
Let's learn a little more about Ozark Mountain Coffee.
Well, I had a career of 30 years here in Springfield and decided I'd like to get out and do something a little bit more creative, something on my own where I'm my own boss, make my decisions, and express myself. And really, coffee roasting is an artisan process. It's a 21-year-old business, started in 1994. We have about 13 different countries of origins. We also do special roasts, French roasts, dark roasts. We're real proud of our organic and fair trade, like our chemical-free decaf. We see it as a process that's helping us keep an eye on the planet. People in this area are in demand of it. We do a lot in Branson and serve the Midwest, wholesale supply, a lot of specialty food stores, gift shops, and restaurants, cafes, and coffee shops. We're here off 65 and CC, just a mile south of Lambert's, and people come in here, they have a good time when they come in here. They get to learn a little bit about the coffee roasting process. We have raw product here. A lot of people have never seen raw coffee in its raw state, so people enjoy it.
All right, ready. Bum, bum, bum. 20 minutes. My name is Tony Garcia, and I'm chef owner of Avanzare. I'm from Mexico. I grew up in Chicago. Bob Noble, which is Noble & Associates, they brought me here in Springfield. For some reason, I always love cooking. I didn't mean that I'm going to be, I didn't know if I'm going to be good out of it or anything, but I always love cooking. I always cook, I always do stuff since I was little, you know. So I don't know why. I just always love to cook, so. Because I know when I bring you something to the table, I know it's the best quality I was able to bring you to the table. Since the bread, since the olive oil, since the sauces, pastas, everything. I think I won't change anything. I just keep doing the same what I'm doing, and if it's more work, I'm just gonna keep doing it.
So one of our main objectives here at Metropolitan Farmer was we wanna really change the way other restaurants are buying their food here in town. You know, working closer with the farmers, helping people here realize that buying local can still be profitable and still be a good business model. The other thing we do here is it's all about change, constantly change the menu, constantly changing with the seasons, get people excited about what's coming next and things like that, and really push ourselves too at the same time. You know, we're a year and a half in and we're gonna continue to build and work on it, and for us it's more about building the overall restaurant community here and uplifting the way restaurants do things, you know, improve the quality, improve, you know, all of those things, and make people more excited about going out and dining and feeding It's not always just about us, but it's about driving the overall business.
Chef, excuse me, chef.
You got it.
I want my all full can of it. Uh-oh, those cars are blowing off. They're calling all the pot, buddy. My strainer. Oh. All right, they got my strainer. It's okay. I see.
You need a strainer?
I got it. I don't need it.
So, Judge Larry, coffee products from Ozark Mountain Coffee are our highlighted ingredients. And as the owner of Ozark Mountain Coffee, how do you hope to see these incorporated into the entrees?
Well, first of all, I'm enjoying the aromas right now. They definitely complement them with the rest of the skills and their knowledge of putting veggies together. I'm curious of how the oils of the coffee are going to be complemented here, because really, when we're roasting coffee, is what I do. We're releasing those oils trapped at the cellular level. So I'm interested in seeing how the oils of coffee works with the rest of their ingredients. You know, I think with the meat, I've seen them use it with the beef, and I've seen experiences where it is a compliment, like a seasoning on the beef. I think they're on track.
Judge Mark, do you have any experience with cooking with coffee?
I drink a lot of coffee, so whenever I'm cooking, I'm drinking coffee, but I've not actually cooked with meat and coffee before. That's very interesting.
Judge Melanie, what are your thoughts on incorporating coffee into an entree dish?
I have put it as a rub on prime rib before, and it really adds to the flavor of it. You know, you kind of scrape it off. And I've made the red-eyed gravy with it, but I think it's going to be wonderful with this beef. I think that the beef looked really good, and I think it's going to really complement it.
All right, chefs, we've reached that halfway mark. You now have 20 minutes remaining to finish your entrees.
See, I did a whole turn right there. Can I check it up over here, bro? Yeah. Let me see you some salt.
Oh, yeah, go right ahead. Sorry, I thought they were grabbing it for you. I think this is salt also.
I stole it. No, that's not salt, that's sugar and stuff.
Oh, is it?
Thank you.
minutes, chefs. 10 minutes remaining. Doing on time?
A little too early.
A little too early? Did you use a special ingredient?
Oh, yeah.
Oh, you did?
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, I'm going to go see how Wes is doing. All right, Chef Wes, what do we got going over here?
Making some sweet potato chips to go with my meatloaf.
Okay, sweet potato chips sounds really good. What you got going on with the carrots?
Those are actually sweet potatoes also. Yeah. It's a sweet potato hash. So I had a little bit of time, so the sweet potato chips are the garnish, and then the sweet potato hash will be the starch to go with the entree.
Okay, well, it smells really good. It smells really down-home cooking.
Stay there. And then add your car.
Chefs, you have 1 minute. Turn, the chefs will present to the judges. Chefs, you were given mystery ingredients from Ozark Mountain Coffee and had to create an entree for our judges. It is now time to present. Chef Wes, please tell the judges what you've made today.
I made a very traditional meatloaf with stuffed with the red bell pepper and onion. A little bit of soy in there to give it a little saltiness. Then I paired that up with the Ozark Mountain Coffee barbecue sauce, a sweet potato hash, and then an artichoke, Swiss chard, and apple salad.
Looks fabulous. Thank you. Okay, I want to try your barbecue sauce. Wow. The dressing on your salad really complements.
What were some of the other ingredients in your barbecue sauce?
The barbecue sauce, chili powder, coffee, obviously. I usually use a steeped coffee left over from the night before. It makes it, you know, it's a nice strong coffee at that point. In fact, I even like a little bit of bitterness because you add sugar to it, a little cumin, salt, pepper, and then sugar to kind of find that balance and a touch of vinegar.
Interesting mix of the apple with the artichoke.
The artichoke with the soft and crisp, and you know, you get a balanced chard and apples are a really good combination. I don't very often work with canned vegetables, so it was definitely a challenging ingredient to figure out the best way to utilize it.
I like how everything works together. Like if you go either direction, they work.
Thank you, Chef Wes. You may return to your station. Chef Tony, what have you prepared as your entree?
Well, these spaghetti meatballs, which is, you can see that in there, and the spaghetti primavera. So I was trying to make something a little bit lighter to go with the meatballs, because I make the meatballs a little bit stronger than normal. And for me, it was pretty easy to do the blocking with the coffee. So then I did the meatballs, pan seared with the coffee across, like a blocking with the coffee in there. So that was an easy combination there. And I put a little olives and a little bit of sparrow just to clean your palate, a little Parmesan cheese on the top. Let's see what you think.
Very fresh.
So, Judge Larry, how does the use of the coffee in Chef Tony's dish compare to the use of the coffee in Chef Wes's dish?
Well, the barbecue sauce, I've got to say, was great. It really complemented the meats there. The complexity of this makes it stand out in a different way. Both are enjoyable. I think the fresh vegetables also with the oils from the coffee made the coffee stand out. So I got to say that the veggies were a nice addition for this.
I know the meatloaf, when he was making it and he smelled the barbecue, I was like, I want some of that too.
Thank you, Chef Tony.
Thank you.
After the break, our chefs prepare to compete in our dessert round, right after this.
Welcome back to Show Me Chefs. Our chefs have created an appetizer and an entree for our judges. Now is the time for the dessert round. The competitors will have 20 minutes to provide a dessert and present it to the judges. Chef, your ingredients are mangoes, peppermint leaf from the pantry, and the highlighted ingredient, bacon, provided by Circle B Ranch Pork.
Chefs, you have 20 minutes. If you're ready, your time begins now.
All right, Tony, I'm gonna be cutting it close on this one.
Yeah, he's gonna be tough. Time is flying.
Oh my God. I'm not gonna make this
Chef.
One.
Chef.
This is gonna be super, super tight.
Gonna be crying. And I don't have toothpicks either, so.
All right, Chef West. You feeling a little behind?
Oh yeah.
This
is gonna be a tight one.
All right, how are you gonna incorporate the mystery ingredient?
The mango and the bacon, I'm gonna make a kind of a traditional, more traditional Thai style dish. Mango and sticky rice with a candied bacon and peppermint something. I'll let you know as soon as I figure it out.
Okay, all right, well, good luck. Chef Tony, I like the creativity.
I'm making a kielbasa for dessert.
Okay, how do you think the judges are going to react to this?
I hope it's edible.
I hope it's edible. I hope so, too. All right, well, good luck to you.
I'm going to need it this time. No trash talking today.
We're Circle B Ranch. We operate a 90-acre pasture-raised, natural-raised hog farm. Another thing that's helped our business success has been our line of sauces, a tomato marinara sauce, barbecue sauce, steak and chop sauce, and a pre-cooked Italian-style meatball. We're animal welfare approved, humane raised and handled approved, which means a third party comes and inspects our farming practices. We had been hobby farmers for years back in New Jersey, so we knew the basics of what animals needed for a healthy lifestyle. So we employed that here, and we decided that hogs were the way to go. We started with 10 gilts and one boar, and in 4 years, built it up to we're well over 300 hogs here at any one time. We breed, farrow, and raise right here. We don't bring any feeder pigs in. nothing like that. Give the pig the essentials that it needs. Give it the, good water, good food, good fencing, and an environment that it's going to be happy in. Our philosophy is a happy hog's a good tasting hog.
So, judges, we're in the dessert round, and it appears that Chef Tony is making mango-wrapped bacon. Looks like that's what he's doing. And that might bring like a sweet and savory combination flavor. What are your guys' thoughts on that? Are you more sweet? Are you more savory? Or do you guys like a combination?
I'll jump on that one, because I think that reminds me a little bit of bacon-wrapped figs or dates that I've had before are delicious. Absolutely wonderful. So I'm anticipating an interesting mix and match of flavors.
Yeah, definitely. Judge Melanie, what are your thoughts?
I like that savory and sweet combination. I think they're doing great, but I think 20 minutes was really pushing it for a dessert. I think they probably would have liked to have borrowed some of the extra time that they had for the main course and put it over here. But I'm looking forward to her. Hopefully it's done.
Judge Larry, what about you? Are you sweet or savory?
Well, I definitely is savory, but the sweet stuff complimenting it always satisfies me. I'm looking forward to some sticky rice here. I think that sounds like a good combination. Work with the sweet mango, and no doubt Tony's going to surprise us with something here.
I'm going to use the opener, Chef.
Oh, right ahead. It's right there.
Couldn't see it. So, I have to say, but I'm ready. So we could do that. The three on each side. Coleslaw is right here. I got time. Let's do it. Why not? It's almost there.
Chefs, you have 1 minute to put the finishing touches on your dessert.
It's like he's stealing your stuff.
Final round of judging. Today we have our desserts being served with Ozark Mountain coffee. Chef Wes, please tell the judges what you've prepared.
So this is kind of a country spin on a traditional Thai dessert. It is a peppermint simple syrup marinated mango with candied bacon, coconut sticky rice, and then a coconut caramel sauce.
Very good. Very good. The rice is a beautiful color.
It's a Thai purple sticky rice. Mm-hmm. So it bleeds out really nicely and colors everything.
It goes great with the bacon.
Yeah, I'm a big proponent of Circle B Ranch. Almost all of our pork at the restaurant is from their farm, so they do a spectacular job.
Thank you, Chef Wes. You may return to your station. Chef Tony, please tell the judges what you've made for them.
All right, so I did some roasted mango wrapped up with the bacon, and I sauteed the blueberries with the coconut milk and a little bit of heavy cream. So, and the same spices I use in the mango, that's what I use also in the sauce, so they kind of combine together. So I hope I didn't went too rich in it.
It's beautiful.
It is beautiful.
It's really beautiful.
that was enough time to crispy it enough. It needed a little bit more, but it was enough to get it just crispy. It
has a good flavor, though. Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Chef Tony. You may return to your station.
Thanks so much.
When we come back, the judges will present their final decision.
Chefs, you were told to create a three-course meal using the ingredients provided. The judges have tasted and discussed your plates and have come up with the final decision on who will be moving on and who will be sent home.
Judge Mark, will you please give your final comments and reveal the winner of the appetizer round?
Absolutely. First, let me say it was really a pleasure being with you this afternoon. Both of you did an amazing job with very challenging ingredients. When everything was said and done, the judges picked Chef Tony for the appetizer.
Thank you. You made it tough, senor. You know, I have my hands up.
Judge Larry, will you please give your final comments and reveal the winner of the entree round?
Well, after they tallied our points separately and back, came back with the score, it's not surprising, the entree was a tie. We couldn't come to a final agreement.
Thank you, buddy.
They were completely different dishes, as you pointed out, Tony, when you came to them. Both very satisfying. I enjoyed both the dishes. It was a good job. I appreciate the time with you this afternoon.
Judge Melanie, will you please give your final comments and reveal the winner of the dessert round?
Okay, the dessert round I thought was the most challenging of all three of the categories. I was impressed with both of them, but Chef Tony, you were the winner.
Thank you. Sure. Man, it was the
judges, what is your final decision?
Chef Tony. Congratulations.
Thank you so much. Thank
well
you.
Done, Chef Wes.
Congratulations, Chef Tony. You will move on to the semifinal round of Show Me Chefs.
Another day of competition by two excellent chefs, but only one can move on to the semifinal round.
We'd like to take a moment to thank all of our sponsors and donators for the ingredients used today.
Join us next week for another exciting episode of Show Me Chefs. Yeah.